Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip video. Today I will show you how to use left joins and fetch joins in a criteria query. But before we begin, if this is your first time here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Now that you've done that, let's get started. In one of my previous Hibernate tip videos, I explained the difference between a join, a left join, and a join fetch clause. I used JPQL in all examples, and Igor asked how he could do the same using JPA's Criteria API. Because the Criteria API presents a few pitfalls, I decided to answer it in a new Hibernate tip. So the question I want to answer today is, how can I create a join, left join, and join fetch clause using JPA's Criteria API? JPA's different join clauses are one of the essential parts of JPQL and the Criteria API. They tell Hibernate which database tables it shall join in the generated SQL query and how it shall do that. Unfortunately, the Criteria API is not as easy to use as most of us would prefer. That's especially the case if you want to use a join fetch clause or select multiple entities. Defining a join clause is pretty simple. You first call the from method on your criteria query object to get a root object. In the next step, you can call the join method to define your join clause based on a managed association. Let's have a look at this in the IDE. In this example, the books attribute of the author entity models a many-to-many association to the book entity. So I can use it in my criteria query to join the author with the book entity. If you activate the logging of SQL statements, you can see the expected SQL statement in the log file. Hibernate uses inner joins to join the author with the book author table and the book author table with the book table. You can define a left join or a right join clause in almost the same way as you create an inner join clause. The only difference is that you need to provide a join type as the second parameter to the join method. Join type is an enum. You can choose between inner, which is the default, left, and right. Let's create a query that selects author and book entities and joins them using a left join. The best way to do that is to create a query that returns tuple instances. You can then call the multi-select method to select author and book entities. The return tuple interface provides a comfortable way to process the result of your query. And as you can see in the code, the creation of the root and the left join is almost identical to the previous example. When you run this code, you can see in the log file that Hibernate generates an SQL query with the expected left join clause. Working with the join fetch clause in a criteria query is a little bit special. First of all, you can't create it using the join method. You need to call the fetch method instead. If you want to define a left join fetch or a right join fetch clause, you need to provide a join type enum value as the second parameter. The second big difference is the return type of the fetch method. The return fetch interface is very similar to the join interface, but it doesn't define a get method, so you can't use it to access any attributes of the join fetched entity. Here you can see an example of such a query. When you execute this code, you can see that Hibernate extended the select clause and added all columns mapped by the book entity. This is the important difference to a standard join clause. The fetch keyword tells Hibernate not only to join, but also to fetch the associated entity. If you don't like to use a join fetch clause, you can use an entity graph instead. It's another way to tell Hibernate to initialize the association. In the following example, I use Hibernate's proprietary graph parser API to pass a string to an entity graph. The executed query is identical to the previous example. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye.